Welcome to a Mars Info channel. Stay tuned for latest global news. The U.S. sanctions against International Criminal Court. The Trump administration is authorizing economic sanctions and travel restrictions against International Criminal Court workers directly involved in investigating American troops and intelligence officials for possible war crimes in Afghanistan. June 11, 2020. The International Criminal Court, ICC, was established as a court of last resort to prosecute offenses that would otherwise go unpunished. It has jurisdiction over four crimes: genocide, crimes against humanity, war crimes, and the crime of aggression. The turbulent relationship between the U.S. and the International Criminal Court, ICC, further exacerbated this week after President Donald Trump authorized sanctions against ICC officials involved in investigations into possible war crimes by U.S. troops or those of its allies. The Trump administration, which has long considered the International Law Forum a threat to U.S. sovereignty, announced the strict punitive measures that Washington generally reserves for use against terror groups and those accused of abusing human rights. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, the country's top diplomat, called the 123-nation's strong tribunal a kangaroo court. Without providing evidence, Attorney General William Barr said that the U.S. Justice Department had received substantial credible information that raises serious concerns about a long history of financial corruption and malfeasance at the highest levels in the Office of the Prosecutor. U.S. officials have also blamed Russia for manipulating the ICC in its favor. Now, is International Criminal Court, ICC? The ICC, a permanent judicial body based at The Hague in the Netherlands, was created by the 1998 Rome Statute of the International Criminal Court, its founding and governing document, and began functioning on July 1, 2002 when the statute came into force. The forum was established as a court of last resort to prosecute offenses that would otherwise go unpunished, and has jurisdiction over four main crimes: genocide, crimes against humanity, war crimes, and the crime of aggression. 123 nations are states parties to the Rome Statute and recognize the ICC's authority, the notable exceptions being the US, China, Russia, and India. Unlike the International Court of Justice, ICJ, the ICC is not part of the United Nations system, with the UN-ICC relationship being governed by a separate agreement. The ICJ, which is among the UN's six principal organs, mainly hears disputes between nations. The ICC, on the other hand, prosecutes individuals as authority extending to offenses committed in a member state or by a national of such a state. The ICC has been criticized for not pursuing investigations in Western countries. All four of its guilty verdicts pronounced so far are in trials from Africa, as well as for working inefficiently. Last year, the court ordered an independent expert review of its own functioning to address these concerns. How Washington is connected to the ICC? The Clinton administration, 1993 to 2001. Was involved in Rome Statute negotiations and signed the document in 2000. However, the next president, George W. Bush in 2002, had the U.S. unsign the statute and signed into law the American Service Members Protection Act to protect U.S. nationals from the ICC's reach. Its differences with the ICC notwithstanding, Washington adopted a positive approach towards the forum during several instances. In 2005, it did not veto a UN Security Council request to the ICC to investigate crimes during the Darfur crisis, and in 2011 voted for Libya's referral to the court. The U.S. also provided critical support in transferring suspects from Africa to the ICC for trial. Thanks for watching. If you like watching international politics, please subscribe our channel. You also follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.